Welcome to an example on determining the length of a leg of a right triangle using the Pythagorean theorem. And sometimes you'll see the Pythagorean theorem written two different ways. The main thing to notice here is that in either case, c squared is on one side of the equation by itself, where c represents the length of the hypotenuse. And the hypotenuse is the longest side of a right triangle, and it's also opposite the right angle. So this would be the hypotenuse. And then A and B represent the length of the legs. And it doesn't matter which leg is A and which leg is B. Let's go and take a look at our example. We're given a right triangle, and we want to determine the length of this leg here, which is represented by the variable x. So for this example, let's go ahead and use the second equation for the Pythagorean theorem. So the hypotenuse has to be C. That's the side which has a length of 18 centimeters. Let's go ahead and label this leg A, we'll label this leg B. So using the Pythagorean theorem, we'll have A squared plus B squared equals C squared, or in this case, X squared plus 14 squared must equal 18 squared. Now let's go ahead and simplify and then solve. So we have X squared plus 14 squared, which is 196, which is 196 equals 18 squared, which is 324. Now we'll go ahead and subtract 196 on both sides of the equation. This would be 0, so we'd have x squared equals 324 minus 196 is equal to 128. And now we'll take the square root of both sides, and we only have to be concerned about the positive square root, or the principal square root, because we know x represents a length. So on the left we'll have x, and on the right we'll have the square root of 128. Let's go ahead and find the perfect square factors to simplify this. We'll do that by making a factor tree. I know that would be the same as 2 times 64. Well, 64 is a perfect square, so we can stop here. The square root of 64 would be 8, so x is equal to 8 square root 2 centimeters. And again, if we want to get a decimal approximation, we would need our calculator. Let's first type in square root of 128. This is approximately 11.3 centimeters. And to check our work, let's go ahead and type in 8 times square root 2 to make sure we get the same decimal value. And we do, which verifies that we did simplify this correctly. I hope you found this helpful.